Good morning. Thank you for joining us with an interview today in support of Engineers Week for Army Corps of Engineers. We have a lot of people really interested in engineering and want to know more about you, your job, engineering in general. So could you tell us your name and position, please?
Sure. My name is Michelle Louis. I'm the Civil Works Structural Design Section Chief. I'm part of the design branch.
Mm-hmm. How long have you been in this design branch?
I've been in the design branch since 2003.
Oh, a long time. Nice.
Yeah.
Could you tell us about the design branch and what a typical day is like for you?
Design branch is responsible for all sorts of design work. Everything from dams to bridges to levees, flood control structures. So many different types of different designs and stuff. A typical day for me, a section chief starts off with making sure my staff is working. Everybody is checking in and everyone's doing well and staying safe. And from there, it's making sure, you know, everyone's got the, you know, enough work to keep them busy. Everyone is hopefully energetic. And if they've got some issues or some problems and they want to discuss, usually I try to start off with that and try to work out some of those issues first.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then move on to more technical design work.
Sounds pretty busy. When you talk about technical design work, you had mentioned bridges, dams, roads. So this job is not the same as being an architect. How is it different?
Architects are primarily, you know, building design. For us on the civil work side, we're more focused on, you know, dams and bridges and that type of structure versus architects are more focused on vertical design.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What is the largest thing you have designed so far?
I think the largest thing I've designed so far is a spillway. We did a spillway out at Folsom Dam recently, and that to me was the biggest structure that I've worked on so far.
Mm-hmm. Sounds pretty cool. Could you tell me more about the design process? Do you draw things out on the back of an envelope? Do you write it down? Is it in your head, on the computer?
Usually it starts off in my head, and I know some other people maybe start, you know, doodling or sketching stuff out on the back of an envelope. For me, it starts off in my head and what I can imagine, how things will look, but it's almost being really creative and trying to, you know, think of all sorts of crazy ideas and then kind of bringing it back down to earth where something looks more realistic, and going from there.
Mm-hmm. So you'd say to be a good engineer, you have to have a good imagination?
I would say so. Mm-hmm. I know engineers aren't usually thought of as being creative people. You know, we're more numbers people, but I think there's an art to being an engineer. And I think that's some you know, the creative part does kick in and it's kind of fun doing that.
Nice. Sounds like you can get a lot of interesting designs out, but sounds like they won't all work. When you thought of a design and you want to build it, like what is your next step to figure out if it's going to work or not work? How do you test out your designs?
I mean, once I get it out of my head and I put it on paper, I do sketch it out. I still like to use pencil and paper and, you know, draw stuff out and see what it looks like in my, you know, on paper. From there, you know, we have the technical side of it where you do use, you know, we check our equations, we use our textbooks, do the math, and from there, you know, try to figure out if our ideas can be, you know, actually built and designed based on the current design codes and things.
Mm-hmm. To you, what would you say makes a design good and what makes a design great?
I think all design is good. The great designs are the ones, I would almost say every design is great. I don't think I've ever worked on a boring design. It's always, it's almost a process where you start off thinking it's going to be okay and down the road, once you're done with it, you look at it and you go, that is an awesome and great design, even though it might be just a simple wall. Once they actually construct it, I think it becomes a very great design.
It sounds pretty nice that you get to see your ideas go from on paper or just in your thoughts to actually being there in the real life. Could you tell me about, if your design doesn't work, how many times have you had to go back to redo something? I'm thinking maybe we don't always get it right the first time, even though we're very smart and we know, you know, lots of things and can talk to people. Is it okay to have to redo it?
Sure. I think I will honestly admit there's always mistakes. My first design for anything will always have some mistakes, and it's it's part of the process. Nothing's ever perfect. We do the best we can. And we do have to go back and redo things. But that's, again, that's not a bad thing. It's just making sure that we have something that's buildable and constructible.
I see. Do you ever use the process of design in your regular life or just at work?
I think I do use it on both. I think my life and work are very much similar. I hate to think of, you know, that I'm an engineer, but also, like I said, I would live my life as an engineer. I can't really separate that out from my personality. So it's also, you know, just part of it.
What is the most interesting parts to you? The beginning, the middle, the end, or all of it?
I think all of it. I think it's the process. I think it's always fun to go through the process. You might not think about that when you're in it, but then once you get to the end, hopefully you're able to look back and go, hey, that was really fun.
Wonderful. What kind of qualities do you think a person needs to be a good engineer?
Good qualities, I would say good. I think you have to be creative. You don't have to like numbers. I know there's the idea that engineers love numbers and science. I think, you know, some of the other skills you learn in school are just as important. English and art, I think those are awesome. I think it's nice to have a good balance of skills. I think engineers, I think it's good to think on your feet and think outside the box.
Very good. Thank you. Is there anything you wanted to share that maybe I didn't ask you that you would like the next generation of engineers to know or think about? Or maybe some considerations if they're trying to decide what kind of engineering is best for them?
I would, you know, don't be intimidated by engineering. I know when I was in school, I didn't know what an engineer was. And I think those qualities that I had as a kid were always there. I just didn't know it at the time until I got further along in school. I went, oh, I've always been meant to be an engineer. Couldn't imagine myself doing anything else. So whatever skills you have, if it's creative, you know, being creative or liking numbers, that all comes into engineering and you know, makes for a good engineer.
Wonderful. Thank you. I'd like to say thanks for taking the time today to do this interview. We are very excited to have our at-home children do some engineering projects, and hopefully they can use the information that you have provided us on their paths to future success in engineering fields.
All right, thanks.